I have two main points. Firstly, on the entire idea of deep debate being necessary and disarmed. And secondly, on the entire of confidence being built upon and debate being a sport. So first, they kept on coming up here and saying that secretaries would be allowed to be in debate after they've gone through the entire experience for 2 years, after they've gone through the experience of debating as a whole, hands-on experience. Now we say, right from the years already told you, why not you do it in Sec 3 and Sec 4? And the reason why we say so is because in Sec 1 and Sec 2, you may not necessarily be at the best of the best of your understanding, but in Sec 3 and 4, you'll be more mature, you'll be more inclined to learn something which you see is important. And subjects like current history, geography and all, these complex subjects can be more better dealt with in Sec 3 and 4, which is why we are given the choice to choose these complex subjects at this age. They also give us the comparison about physics being complicated. We say, yes, physics is complicated, but ladies and gentlemen, physics is a core subject. It is something which can be used to go into a science field which is so wide. We say that that these students see the purpose of physics, and physics is something which
will
be seen,
well,
thank you, sir. Physics is something which will be seen on a report card. It will be something which is graded. Unlike debate, which you spend more than 2 days doing something which you may not necessarily be interested in and waste your time.
Bunch of information.
No, thank you, sir. Also, this is that with under much stress, the child will be able to cope with it and will be able to build himself much better. We say that is not true. Stress in such an education system passes thesis and adds on to his or her problems. No, thank you, sir. And we say that in stress, the child may not be able to handle this situation and only leads to the downfall of the child. Also, we say that why not you use those 2 years to give that child the option to look for something which he's
worth of information,
has already had an interest in, and develop it, and use the developing skills to stick with that certain sport or CCA for 4 straight years, so that he can use that time wisely and productively.
Second point,
will be about the idea of confidence. They give us the idea that confidence will be built or be dealt with. We tell them that confidence is built. In essence, my first speakers already told you how a child will walk away with the teacher and present to you. A teacher will give feedback. I like being forced to the debate round where we're given the verdict and you're not necessarily given the best of the best feedback. Also, we say that confidence can be built up in many areas. No, thank you, sir. A parent can build up a child's confidence. You build up your own confidence when you speak to your friends, when you engage in socializing. Not by sitting down 1 hour and being pressurized or to think on something on your own feet without you being seen. No, thank you, sir. And we say that there are a wide range, they said that there are a wide range of subjects gained. We say that there are alternatives. There are other ways to gain these wide range of subjects. There are newspapers. If you are really interested in listening or knowing these subjects, then you take the initiative and go ahead. Well, thank you, sir. I'd like to say that we're not saying to know to debating as a whole. We are encouraging it. We are doing our best effort to show debating under full light. But we do not feel we should force the other 29 students to go ahead and do debating when we're not even interested in it. It loses the whole purpose of debating and its benefits. So now moving on to a substantive about how our education system does not necessarily match this their policy, and how these entire 2 days spent debating can be used to better productivity.
So
thank you, sir. So firstly, about the entire idea of our education system. In this current age of education system, it requires dedication, it requires time, and through this education system, students are bound to face stress. Now we argue that stress is important, it drives a student, but too much stress
point
is
not. Information.
Okay, sir. Debate is an art. Debate is something which requires a lot of thinking, a lot of knowledge which you need to require. Thank you, sir. Extra knowledge and too much knowledge can bring a child down, can bring a child to be too complicated and not think on his feet. Also, we say that, we give you an example, a normal student, thank you, sir, has a minimum of 7 subjects, and he goes, and on top of that, he has a burden of CCA. So, with a burden of 2 out of 7,
yes, sir. So we think that debate actually teaches you how to carefully manage your time. Because when you're given 1 hour in prep, you're allocating your time to different areas of the debate.
Sir, measurement of time does not necessarily have to be done taught in debating. And how are you so sure that in debating people manage time? People do go over time, and it takes a lot of years to learn how to measure time. And there are alternatives. People can measure time for other courses. You don't have to be forced to learn anything. But thank you, sir. So, now, moving on. So why is stress bad? We said it, bring out the child, and you have 2,000 students learning something which they do not want, and it just leads on to more and more pressure on a child, and he or she will not be able to handle it. We should not want to be one in his society. This stress can reflect on a child's grades, his academic process, and his relationships. Secondly, all this time spent on something which you do not want, and perhaps only 3 students want, is time wasted. Because those students who are interested can go ahead and learn debating, can go ahead and excel in debating. they will excel in. Like my first case showing about Singapore and other countries who have excelled in debating without forcing it. However, we say that there's a vanishing problem of opportunity cost in terms of time. Because there's no time to do what you love under such a hard, such a hectic school schedule, and you'll be too drained out. So if you want to get an hour, we show you that you don't need to go and spend time doing debating classes and do something which you are not interested in. Spend 2 hours pointlessly, rather spend your time doing something which you are interested in, which you believe you see talent in, and not the school which sees that is necessarily important. With so much limited time, the child, like first thing I said, should have the right to make a choice of whatever he or she wants to use, the right to choose what he or she wants to use of the time. He will be really the example of mother tongue, Chinese. If the child is not fluent in Chinese, he'll be relieved of the stress. He can use that extra time to spend time doing other activities, to relax, and these activities will bring out the best of him, rather than doing something she or she does not want. So, ladies and gentlemen, we argue that there may be little or perhaps less exposure in our world, but this fall is something minor. But in their world, the sense of debating is lost. Because debating is seen as something hated. Debating is seen as something to be gone, and just spend time there doing something we should not want. Which is why we say, you walk the outside and you see the sense of debating, and